40 metres can be a bit of a challenge, but Wendy and I went to Bude again down in Cornwall, and the Bude house has got a tiny strip of grass at the front of the property, and that's it. Okay, and I never considered that you could, that we could squeeze an antenna in there, but needs must, really. And I, one day I thought, do you know what, I think I'm going to, rather than going back out in the car and go portable, I'll see if I can lever this a DX Commander Expedition in there. So I'll show you how I got on doing that. And then I just want to discuss a couple of other options that I could have done and that you could do if you got a strip of grass. So this strip of grass is literally not even 2 meters. You know, it's 4 to 5 feet deep. It's flat anyway. I mean, well, did it work? Let's have a look. Let's roll the tape and see how I got on. Then we'll come back, because I've got an idea of 2 or 3 other antennas I could have used here with a bit of wire and a bit of coax and like a dipole connector. See how we get on anyway.
Mike 0, X-ray Tango Portable from Victor Echo 3, Oscar Juliet November.
Kilo Golf 1 Zulu, Richie, hello. Very.
Okay, Fox Guatemala 5, Germany Papa.
Yeah, hello, Fox Golf 5, Golf Papa. Guadeloupe, Alain, hello, how are you?
Kilo Alpha 2, Kilo Alpha 2,
Kilo Alpha 2, Kilo,
hello.
2 Echo 3, Quebec Zulu. KE3QZ, hello, nice to meet you. I've got a Kilo, again, nice and slowly. Okay, Kilo 1, Radio Tango Ocean. Scott, Kilo Tango 4, Radio Alpha Mike. Is that you, Greg? About 5 and 2, over.
Radio Alpha Mike,
Kilo 3,
Echo Lima Golf.
Kilo 3, Echo Lima Golf. Eric.
Kilo Charlie 3, Sierra, November.
Okay, I have Kilo Charlie 3, Sugar, Italy, November. Got it. November 2, Yankee Tango Alpha, you're 4 and 2.
Okay, so that was quite good fun, because that was at night, and at about midnight, 1 o'clock, when Newfoundland was just getting dark, and then it would have been New York, Florida, would have gone dark as well. I did it, I was on the radio again the next day, but we'd had a big solar flare or something, and it was a bit of a blackout, so it was a bit of a washout. But anyway, I proved that, and I recently launched a video, Will It Work? It was called Will It Work? Which is, if you can get some RF into something, it'll work, right? I don't know how well it'll work, but I had a really crappy SWR on 20 metres because of the stays that went round the decking area, made of stainless steel, about a quarter wave, and I think that was getting in the way, but anyway. So let's just have a muck around what else we could have done, and I'm just going to draw this little patch of land, right, for fun, and Google Earth is telling me, well, that there is 11 metres. I could have probably fitted maybe a little bit more, maybe 12, 13, 14 metres, but anyway. What can you do with a tiny strip of land if you did want to get onto 40 metres? So, not so long ago, Tom and I built a linear-loaded dipole for 80 metres. And how that works is that an 80-metre inverted V should have its legs, depending on the height above ground, a few other variables, its legs will be around 19.5 metres each leg. Okay, but what I did, it's out with a rule of thumb calculation, and I'll put the link to that video underneath here. I calculated we could have done, we could come back. So there's the feed point down here, and we made it 12 and a half meters long, 12.5 meters long, not 19.5. So that was compact. So over here, one, if you did want to get on 40 metres with a fairly good SWR curve and all the other variables, and we've got, you know, 10, 12 metres to play with, just a little strip of land down by the side of a house or whatever else, you could half that, 6.25 meters. I'll bet you could make a shorty 40, right? Where you've got your coax, and we'll just come at a side view here. I'll draw it up here. 6.25 meters, but linear load your element. So your element is going to be 12, 13 meters long. And then to tune it, all right, all you do is you just chop a bit off slowly until you get the perfect tune at 7.15, 7.25, or whatever you're after. By the way, if we're looking straight down on this now, so it's not inverted V, it's just like this. There it is. From here to here, a shorty 40, linear loaded. If it still doesn't fit and you need more room, well, do this. Make it a Z shape. You could have another couple of meters there. You come there and back, and there's your feed point. Because the ends here aren't actually doing much. Your current on a tuned dipole with quarter wavelength legs, right, so half wavelength in total, your main current, your main RF is actually coming off at the middle. All right, so these bits here will just be doing the tuning. And I've done all sorts. I've done inverted V, and then one end came this way and the other end I think went that way, you know, so it was a really strange shape. I could draw that on MMANA, sorry. You know, my little drawing program that I use for doing this stuff, just to demonstrate. But we won't, not today. All right, let's keep it easy. So what other ways? We've got a simple vertical, and we did that one, all right? And you just put your radials like that. That would work as well, a simple vertical. There it is. A linear loaded dipole. Now, a loop would be very difficult because although you could probably just about squeeze a loop in all the way around here, it's a funny shape, okay? And it starts to look like a folded dipole. The other way of doing this is, let's draw this again. It's about 10 meters long. If you had a telescopic pole that you could go up 10 meters and then along, and you could get about 10 meters there and about 10 meters there. There's an inverted L for 80 meters. Hammer's alive. You get on 80 that way. If you went up 5 and along 5, do this again. Actually, this is really easy. You could go to a wood yard and get yourself a 20-foot long banister rail or something. 20 feet, just under 5 meters. And then just go along a bit to the nearest, you know, bush, and just trim it to suit. Inverted L would work. You will need some radials underneath it. Just whatever length, doesn't matter. Just couple that sort of to the ground. Inverted L or an end fed. Now, an end fed would have to be 20 meters in total length, which is actually what I was thinking about when I started drawing this, actually. In the back of my mind, it was an end fed, but that's, you do need a bit of length, okay? You need half a wavelength for an end fed on 40. But inverted L, that would work really well, wouldn't it? I mean, actually, there's a little shed here, right? Which I'll try and find a picture if I can. You could just bolt a wooden banister rail, you know? I mean, how much is that? Not a lot. I've done that, you see. Go along, inverted L. That'll get you on 40 as well. I can't think of any more right now. I think the inverted L would work really well. I think a Z-shaped, linear-loaded 40-meter dipole, you should be able to get that in inside 7 or 8 meters, actually. You could really squeeze that in. If you would like me to build this Z-shaped thing and demonstrate it and do the measurements, let me know in the comments and we'll string one up in the field. But straight vertical, the Z, as I call it, Z-shaped dipole, linear-loaded dipole, inverted L, end fed. I can't think of anything else. A loop, I think, on a strip of land, you're into the folded dipole bit, and I don't think it would work so well. All right, any other ideas you've got, stick them in the comments, and if you want me to build this Z thing, yeah, let me know as well, and we'll give that a go. If you've built one of these and had some success or failures, let us know as well. Always a pleasure. All right, next video is coming up here. Thanks for tuning in today. It's been quite good fun, this one, as a project. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.